Well, let's tell you more about this story where at least 10,000 staff of HSBC are expected to be shown the way out as the banking group plans to slash jobs in order to reduce costs. Now, the job cuts will focus mainly on high-paid roles. HSBC could announce the beginning of the latest cost-cutting drive and job cuts when it reports third-quarter results later this month. Now, the reported job cuts come after the lender said it will be laying off about 4,000 people this year and issued a gloomier business outlook with escalation of a trade war between China and the United States, an easing monetary policy cycle unrest in its key Hong Kong market, and Brexit. Well, Juliana Olayinka is ready to give us more information about this latest announcement from the HSBC and other market headlines. Hello, Juliana.
Hey, Bissy. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon. You're right there in London where the HSBC's headquarters is located. What reactions have you seen since this news broke?
Well, HSBC have declined to comment at present, but this morning their shares were down 0.07%. It's still a rumour, but yes, there were reports circulating this weekend that there would be 10,000 job cuts, which is quite a substantial amount considering they've got about 250,000 people working for them across the globe. Earlier this year, we spoke about it on this programme, their CEO, John Flint, was pushed out, and some of the reasons that were cited were, of course, Brexit, of course, as well. There's the Hong Kong protest, considering that lots of HSB's current market is in Asia. And then as well, Bissy, we've got the US-China global trade war. So it's very tricky at the moment for lots of banks. And it's not just HSBC that have cut jobs. We've also seen it in Deutsche Bank. They cut about 15,000 jobs earlier this year, as well as Citigroup and Barclays. It is very, very tough. And of course, my colleague in Frankfurt was talking about the interest rate cuts, which means banks are receiving less and less money. But, you know, again, it is only a rumour. We know earlier this year there were about 4,500 jobs that were reduced when John Flint was taken out. And there are some suggestions that these job cuts may indeed affect Europe, because in Asia, which is HSBC's strongest market, they're receiving double-digit returns and they're not receiving that in Europe. So if it does hit home and they do confirm it, which some people suggest it will be confirmed when they release their Q3 earnings at the end of this month, it's going to particularly hurt those on big pay packages who are based in the continent.
Well, let's talk about cryptocurrencies, and the number of investigations into UK cryptocurrency businesses has surged over the past year. Well, this is still a degree of confidence that products reaching consumers are less likely to be scams.
Well, yes and no, Bissy. I think the reason why the FCA have released these figures is because they do want to relay some sort of confidence in consumers. It's been reported that over the past couple of years, up to £27 million have been scammed out of people that are trying to invest in Bitcoin and cryptocurrencies. But the head of the Financial Conduct Authority, the body that is doing these investigations, their head, Andrew Bailey, said only invest in cryptocurrencies if you're willing to lose all your money. Now, that's a pretty sharp warning. And it really is basically saying that if you're going to invest in cryptocurrencies, it's almost like gambling. There is no win-win situation there. But they are trying. Of course, we know a lot of people are trying to make their money in the digital currency world. We've got Facebook with their Libra coin, which is due to be out next year. And that's obviously under increased scrutiny, particularly as Donald Trump doesn't like the sound of it. Central bank governors have whiffed up their nose to cryptocurrencies, but it's a pretty dangerous market. And of course, even though they've released these figures to say that they're trying their best to stop fraud, they're saying don't put your money in it if you don't want to lose your money.
All right, Juliana, before you go, unpack today's numbers from the equities and currencies markets today, and of course, expectations for the week.
Well, let's have a look at those numbers specifically at intraday. The FTSE All Share is up 0.12%. The FTSE 100 is up 0.27%. And the FTSE 250 is down at 0.23%. A tough day for sterling. Again, in currencies, the British pound is down on the US dollar by 0.05%. Also down on the euro by 0.14%. And down on the Japanese yen by 0.10%. Seems like global markets across the world are holding their breath, awaiting those long awaited talks on Thursday with US and China in Washington.
Thanks, Juliana.
Thank you, Bissy.
The markets in Asia were mixed today as investors awaited a fresh round of U.S.-China trade negotiations expected to begin later this week. Japan's Nikkei 225 closed 0.16% lower at 1,375.25, and the TOPIX index finished its trading day largely flat. South Korea's Kospi closed fractionally higher, with shares of Hyundai Motor gaining 1.19%. In Australia, the ASX 200 advanced 0.71%. But ahead of this week's trade talks between the world's two largest economies, there are reports that Chinese officials are growing hesitant to pursue a broad trade deal with the U.S. And talking about the U.S., stock index futures were lower this morning, with the Dow futures indicated a negative open of nearly 150 points. Futures on the S&P and NASDAQ were also slightly lower. Well, the moves in pre-market trade come after a media report suggested Chinese officials were increasingly reluctant to agree to a broad trade deal pursued by President Donald Trump. Let's take a breather from those numbers now. U.S. energy giant ExxonMobil is on the verge of finalizing its investment in Mozambique's lucrative liquefied natural gas fields. Exxon's Rovuma LNG project, jointly operated with Italian firm Eni, will produce, liquefy and sell natural gas from three reservoirs located in the area four blocks offshore Mozambique's northern coast. Exxon expects 17,000 tons of liquefied petroleum gas per year during the production phase, with the signing of an initial investment decision paving the way for the massive infrastructure project to begin. Exxon estimates the fields, which are due to come online in 2024, will cost $30 billion to develop. The foreigners offloaded South African stocks at the fastest pace in 2 years last week as worries about the state of the global economy helped spur an exit from riskier assets. Figures from the Johannesburg Stock Exchange operator show offshore investors were net sellers of 10.7 billion rand or $711 million of the country's equities in the 5 days ending October the 4th. But that's the heaviest week of outflows since September 2017. South African stocks fell 5.8% in the 3 months to the end of September, and that's their worst third quarter performance since 2011. Appetite for South African equities has been hurt by concerns about global growth, the prolonged trade war, and the moribund local economy. Business Incorporated continues just in a moment. Please stay with us.